Greetings, Eric Backer, New Zealand naturopath, author of Canning the Country. I've got a question here from somebody. Is frozen fruit okay to eat while on a candida diet? Well, have you assessed to see if you've got candida first? If you say yes, I've tested, I'm positive for candida, I've got a 1 or 2 plus culture, you know, issues like that, I would say it's not a good idea to eat fruit. Because generally people who show a positive for candida on a stool test especially, they often have multiple issues, and they're playing right into the hands of bad bacteria, low beneficial bacteria, and they're going to just build the yeast infection counts up by doing this. Now, lots of people disagree with me there, but this is my personal experience based on a hell of a lot of patients I've seen. I watched a very interesting YouTube channel of an American doctor, a very interesting guy. I won't disclose his name, you know. I don't like to embarrass people or say things out of context, but I found a lot of the videos to be BS, because this particular person was saying that you should eat lots and lots of fruit when you've got candida. And in fact, it's a fallacy that fruit doesn't affect yeast infection at all. Fruit was alkaline, it was cleansing. And every time I looked at the comments underneath this guy's videos like that, there are a lot of people who totally disagreed with him, said they had major reactions eating bananas, for example. So this guy is even telling people to eat up to 7 to 10 pieces of fruit a day. I mean, that's just crazy. It's just not a good idea. You can eat some fruits, and as your gut improves and the candida count goes down, you can slowly include fruit. And when candida is shown to be gone, and you no longer suffer from gas or bloating or diarrhea or constipation for fruit, you can be like me and eat, you know, 3 or 4 pieces a day, no problem at all. I would tend to eat fruit on its own as a separate meal away. I don't mix it in with other foods. With the exception of berries, which I'll put into my cereal in the morning or in smoothies. But I wouldn't have a piece of steak, for example, or a chicken meal with some vegetables, and then have, like, you know, an apple and a banana straight after that. It's just really causing problems, even healthy people. Frozen fruit, not a good idea. I think what was acceptable with candida would be frozen berries. Frozen blueberries probably would be okay. But not really frozen fruit drinks, for example, or sweet frozen fruits like oranges. Not a good idea. Okay? Many people like frozen fruit because of the coldness and the sugar content. So I think you should put those things on hold until you've got rid of candida, or got it down to a very fine level where you're not reacting to these kind of foods anymore. So how about we hold on the fruit? Okay? Try frozen coconut. That's not bad at all. Frozen coconut with some berries mixed through that is very, very tasty. Thanks for tuning in.